happened? Mwamba, he had his cardiac arrest on the pitch. You were there. How did you take this? How did it make you feel? What happened?
It was a bad moment in my life.
Did you know how wrong it was going?
No.
Did you think he was going to die?
Yes, but before he left the pitch, I remember I start to pray. And then you can see the miracle can happen, because it's a miracle, it's really a miracle guy, you know? And now what I know is you got only one life and you have to live your life.
Who's your favorite manager?
Favorite manager will be Mourinho. After every game, he will tell you what was wrong, even if you won. Sometimes he went to see me and said, William, ask me why you did that, you know? And for me, it was good because I wanted to improve. And he liked his team improve. Because now, I think some manager, you know, if you win, they don't say nothing. But you make some mistake in the game. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you can be lucky. For me, Arsene Wenger, it's very good to give the opportunity for the young players to play. He doesn't put pressure on them. So the young players can show what they can do. If Mourinho had the young players, I don't think it would be the same. Mourinho need to have the players who have the experience, the players who understand very quick. Arsene had the players who had the experience, and he won some trophy with them.
Yeah, yeah, I feel like there's one of them that nurtures the players. It's like a dad. And the other one who doesn't even have time for that, but he's really good with, you know, he's not got time for you to have to learn this and this and that. It's just like, you know what you need to do, you're good at what you do, do this, do that.
It's right, right, because with Mourinho, you know, we didn't have to speak on the pitch, really, because everybody know what they have to do. May I remember when I was with Chelsea, I didn't have to speak a lot, you know. When I went to Arsenal, it was different because the players was younger, you know. And with Tottenham, it was different as well, you know. With Harry Redknapp, you know, it was completely different. So for me, yeah. For me, the best was Jose Mourinho.
Now let's talk about the end of your career, the feelings that you have towards all of it, because you are approaching the twilight of your career. How does it feel to see other younger footballers perhaps taking your place a little bit?
It's a football, you know. You can't play until 40 years old, you know. Now I think the club want to put their money on the young players because they are younger, they are quick, you know, and if they are good, they can sell them, you know. So now you for the player like me, it can be a little bit difficult.
Did you feel yourself getting older?
Slowly, yes. You know, I'm not quick as I was when I was young. But with my experience, I can have the good position. I read the game very quick, you know, so I don't have to wait to see the ball in the space to run. I run before the ball goes.
The career of a footballer is a lot shorter than the normal career. I mean, you are still a very young man at 35, 7, 8, 40 years old, but you're, as a footballer, you're no longer a young person, and they can take it really, it could be a very difficult stage, the after football life. Have you thought about it?
Yeah, I thought about it, and I can tell you it's not easy. Even if I'm still young, you know, it's very difficult to know what I'm going to do after football. You know, sometimes people said to me, oh, why try to be a manager, you know? But sometimes I want to be out of the football. At the moment, I'm not busy, you know? So it's not easy. But I try to know what I want to do, you know, because I really want to do something with the passion.
So you're a bit conflicted on whether to stay in football after, when you finish, or to carry on with something completely different?
Yeah, but I don't know what I'm going to do. But maybe I have to be brave and, you know, to try to pass all my lessons to be a manager.
When you had your issues, all those controversies that you had, moving from one club to another and sitting down, did this affect your family life?
No, because I stayed in London, and that was very important for me, you know. When I decide to stay in London or to play for Arsenal or Tottenham, I was thinking about my family, because I know it's not easy, you know, to change a country, you know, every maybe 2-3 years. When you have kids, it's not easy as well, you know. So for me, it was important to have the basis, you know, to in London. I don't think my family was not affected about the club I play for.
Not about the club that you played for, but perhaps the deceptions that you had, the sadness that you might have felt, the downs, the, you know, your wife, she loves you, and so it must hurt her to see you being her, or you might be home and not act the same way as you would.
To be the wife of the footballer is not easy. You know, because when you, after the game, you know, you can be very angry, you go back home, you know, you don't want to speak, you know, you feel sad, and sometimes your family doesn't understand why. So you have to explain to them. But when you have a family, the family can help you as well, you know, just to switch off with the football, and I was lucky.
Do you get scared that when you leave football, when football finishes, right now you're William Gallas, I mean, you're one of the greatest, but are you worried that you're not going to be as current that you are now? It's going to be something that might be a little bit more difficult to take.
I will be happy.
Really?
Yes. Because what the people have to understand is I'm the guy who are very shy. What is very funny sometimes, you know, when people ask you the pictures, you said yes. And sometimes the pictures take too long. And people start to walk around you. Who's that guy? Oh, is that player? Oh, okay. And slowly you got many people around you, and me, I start to sweat. You know, with the guy who wants to take the picture, and I said, are you ready? And he said, yes. So let's do it, quick. And then I leave.
Where do you want to play for now? What's your goals? Where do you want to go?
Outside of Europe.
Really?
Yeah. Almost 19 years in Europe, and I gave everything, so now I'm a little bit tired, you know, and I would like to go somewhere I can play with the passion again. At the end of your career, all the ex-footballers told me, normally you play with the fun, but for me I didn't play with the fun at the end of my career. Even if you have your experience, you have to teach the players who are around you. But before, you have to be good. Because if you are not good, the young players, they won't respect you. They will respect you if you are still good. You know, they will listen to you, you know. If I play outside of Europe, you know, it would be different. You know, the people won't say, oh, he's 36, he's too old. They will see me in a different way. They will say, oh, he played for Chelsea, Arsenal, Tottenham, he played for the national team. He will come with his experience, he will teach us.
Right now you're earning a very good wage. When you stop working, which is quite young, are you scared that this not living on the same level, perhaps?
More simple, you know.
You want a more simple life?
Yeah, I will have a more simple life, and that would be good for me, you know. Because when you are players, you know, you want to do everything. You want to go out, to buy the big cars, to have a nice watch, you know. But that is not really the life, you know. But you will understand at the end of your career, when you are inside, it's difficult to understand.
So we've spoken about your very impressive career with Chelsea, Arsenal, Tottenham, but what we haven't spoken about is your international career, because you played for France. That's amazing. Talk to us about that experience, that feeling, and also the feeling of perhaps not being with them anymore and how that feels.
It was, when I was young, it was one of my targets to play for the national team. For my first cup, I remember I cried. Because, you know, I was 24, and, you know, I realized I did something. I didn't want to play only one or two cups. I wanted to go very far. So it means to play a World Cup, you know, that was as well one of my targets. You know, for me, when you play for the national team, you have to select the best 24 or 25 players. And I think in 2010, I was one of the best defenders for the French national team. During the World Cup, I make mistake. You know, I was not good. I was not at my level. You know, but after I had when I went to Tottenham, I had a good answer. You know, because everybody said, "Oh, William Gallas is finished," and I prove again, I was still here. I was still there. You know. And in September, October, I was one of the best defenders for the French national team. and the manager didn't select me. And I was disappointed.
There's a lot of, in your story, what you've said today, there's a lot of highs, but there's also a lot of lows. Do you feel like you've done, you've achieved your goals? Do you feel like there's more goals to go? Or are you happy? Are you disappointed?
Where I'm coming from, I would say I'm very happy about what I did in football. It's true, I wanted to win more trophy, maybe to win that World Cup in 2006. But the life, you know.
Do you want more for your future?
I can do another thing. So it would be very important. It would be important for me to have a target about what I'm going to do.
So this show is about job heroes, and it's a way of inspiring people, and you've inspired millions of young footballers. It's important for them to know, who was your hero growing up and who is your hero now?
My hero when I was young was players like Marcel Desailly, Lilian Thuram, and Laurent Blanc. For me, that three players was the best players in the world. And I wanted to be like them. So I had the opportunity, I was lucky, I had the opportunity to play with that three players. So every training, I was watching them, you know, to see how they play, how they move, you know, and to try to be like them. And now, my hero, I don't know, I would say maybe my son. One of my son, you know.
Thank you for this. I've known you for a little while, and I've always really, really, really liked you, always been really fond of you, and I'm just so happy that I did this, and I'm so happy to be sat here with you, and I think your story was really touching and really amazing, and I really want you to know that I'm really thankful for this.
Thank you. It was a pleasure to speak to you. Like I said to you, you know, I don't give too many interview, you know. I will say it's maybe one exclusive interview from William Gallas.